स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ अजीत प्रताप सिंह। टुडे इन दिस वीडियो ऑफ क्लास सिक्स साइंस आई विल टेल यू अबाउट द डेफिशिएंसी डिजीज कॉस्ड बाय द लैक ऑफ विटामिन्स एंड ऑल्सो ड्यू टू द लैक ऑफ मिनरल्स। ओके, इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो स्टूडेंट्स आई टोल्ड यू अबाउट द डेफिशिएंसी डिजीज कॉस्ड ड्यू टू द लैक ऑफ carbohydrates, proteins and fats. In this, I told you about the disease that is Kwasarkor, that was caused by the lack of proteins, and marasmus also, that is caused by the all three nutrients like carbohydrates, proteins and fats. Okay, so today I'll tell you some of the diseases caused by the lack of vitamins and minerals. So let's start with the vitamins first. As we all know that vitamins and minerals both are required for our body in small amounts, and both are known as protective foods also because they protect our body from various diseases. And if we will not take sufficient amount of food or sufficient amount of food items which are rich in vitamins and minerals, then our body will suffer from a lot of diseases. Okay students, so we'll talk about some of the diseases. First of all, we'll talk about the lack of vitamins, and the first disease which is caused due to the lack of vitamins is scurvy. Scurvy is a very common disease that is caused due to the lack of vitamin C, and vitamin C is also known as ascorbic acid. Okay students, the main symptoms of scurvy disease are swelling and bleeding of gums. This is the main characteristics of scurvy disease. Okay students, and also our wounds do not get healed very quickly. This is also one of the symptom of scurvy disease. In the 16th and 17th centuries, sailors who went on long voyages, they suffered from this disease first of all, and they did not get fresh fruits to eat during the voyage. And in the year 1747, a doctor named James Lind discovered that if these sailors were given the lemons and oranges, the disease was cured very quickly, because as we all know students, the main sources of vitamin C are oranges, lemons, all citrus fruits, I can say, or all kind of fruits which are in category of citrus fruits. Okay, which are sour in taste. Okay students, apart from this, we can also get vitamin C from amla, tomato as well, and as well as from pineapple. So these are the very very important sources of vitamin C. Okay students, so this is how the discovery of scurvy took place from there on, and this was happened due to the lack of vitamin C. Now the next slide, the second kind of disease that is caused by the lack of vitamin D and calcium and phosphorus as well is called rickets. Rickets is a disease which is generally of the bones. So we can say rickets is the disease of bones. Okay students, and in children generally, those who suffer from rickets, their bones become very softer because they suffer from rickets. Okay, and hence they get bent and deformed as well. Bow legs, as you can see in this diagram of a girl child, and pigeon type chest. Apart from this, the bending of the spine and symptoms, these are the main symptoms of this disease. Okay students, so there may be also a pain in the bones and loss of tooth enamel as well. So these are the common symptoms of rickets. In adults, the bones become brittle meaning the bones are not very strong and bones can be broken very easily or can be fractured very easily or very quickly. Okay students, rickets, as I told you, is caused by the lack of vitamin D. And vitamin D, you can fulfill the requirement of vitamin D by the sunshine of the morning sun rays, especially in the winter season, because sunshine vitamin D is also known as the sunshine vitamin. Okay, and we also get vitamin D. Apart from this, we can cure this disease by calcium and phosphorus also, if we take the amount, the kind of food in which the calcium is and phosphorus is present. Okay students, now the third kind of disease is known as anemia. Okay, this is also a very common disease in our society, and it is caused by a mineral called iron in our diet. Okay, so if we will not eat especially the green leafy vegetables, because green leafy vegetables are the main sources of iron, then we will suffer from anemia. Okay students, and it is a disease in which there is a deficiency of a substance called hemoglobin. And hemoglobin, as you know, hemoglobin is a very very important part of our red blood cells, because it carries oxygen to all cells of our body. So this is the main function of hemoglobin. And those people who suffer from anemia, in them the hemoglobin, the blood is unable to carry the full supply of oxygen to the cells of the body. Okay, a person which suffers from this disease looks pale. These are the common symptoms of this disease. They get tired very quickly as well. Apart from this, they suffer from a loss of appetite. Appetite means they never feel hungry. Okay, so these are the main symptoms of anemia. Another type of anemia results from the lack of vitamin B12. So the vitamin B12 is also an important source of, we can say, the green leafy vegetables. And if we will not take right amount of green leafy vegetables in our diet, then our body will definitely suffer from anemia. In this disease, there is a reduced formation of RBCs in the body. The next one is goiter. Goiter is also a mineral which is caused by the lack of mineral called iodine in our diet. And as we all know that goiter can be removed from our body if we eat regular amount of iodized salt in our diet. And that's why the Tata salt is very very important and right kind of salt available in the market, which we can use in our food. Okay, the thyroid gland situated in the neck region becomes swollen. These are the symptoms of goiter. And there is a reduced production of chemical called thyroxine, and thyroxine in our body controls the growth of our body. A child which suffers from goiter generally shows slow growth of both physical and mental part. Goiter used to be very common among people, those who live in Himalayan region in our country. But nowadays, iodine content of the soil and water was very low in those areas. But nowadays, consumption of iodized salt has generally reduced the chances of goiter in those areas also. So this is how we can eradicate from this diseases. So that's it in this video.